Former spokesman for D.C. Mayor Muriel Bowser leaving the Democratic Party and accusing the president of destroying the country.
Yeah, new Republican Victor Jimenez switching sides as the president sees just a 36% wow. approval rating. Joining us now, the aforementioned Victor Jimenez. Good morning to you, sir. So why did you switch parties?
Can you repeat the question?
Why did you decide to ditch the Democratic Party, as the full screen says on the bottom?
There are many reasons as to, you know, why I switched parties, but one of them would be immigration policies. You see what's going on in the border right now, and what's so-called the new immigration policy. I don't think we have an immigration policy if we don't respect the border. If we don't secure the border, we don't have an immigration policy. If anyone who wants to come to this country, who wants to cross the border, can cross the border illegally, then our immigration policy is just a bunch of words on a piece of paper that nobody respects. So that's one reason. Another reason would be unemployment. We hit a 50-year low unemployment rate, right before the pandemic hit. And right now, what you're seeing, especially in my home state of Virginia, is businesses struggling to hire people because they really don't have the resources to pay them because they were hit so hard during the pandemic and lockdowns. And so I just got tired of the same rhetoric. And I'm like, you know what? I'm done with this. I can't take it. I need to be true to my values.
Victor, do you expect to see more Democrats rejecting Biden and the party come the midterms?
Oh, absolutely. Absolutely. We saw a 55% turnout of Hispanic voters in Virginia voting for Glenn Youngkin. And I feel like we're going to see that in 2022, and we're going to see that in 2024. Absolutely, 100%.
Wow. You know, I was reading some of the some of your perspective, some of the things that you sent to producers, and one thing caught my eye. You said, being Hispanic and Black, I should be Democrat by default, but I am going against their narrative, and I feel like that's right now everything is crumbling for Democrats. But going back to the racial issue, we did hear President Biden on the campaign trail say that if you vote for President Trump, you're not Black. Why is there this this sort of sense that you have to vote by race? And how does it feel to sort of break that mold?
So I feel like Democrats have gone, you know, have run the same narrative for years. And a lot has to do with misinformation, especially in the Hispanic community. You can see that Spanish news networks are mostly run by liberals. It's liberal news outlets. And I feel like, actually, Fox News should start Fox News en Español, because a lot of the misinformation that the Hispanic community receives comes from these networks, like CNN in Spanish, Telemundo, Univision. And we need to break that mold. We need to start informing the community, the Hispanic community, better so that they can make better decisions in the future, in 2022 and 2024. We need that. So Fox News, get on it.
Yeah, let's do it. To follow up on that.
That's a very good idea.
Yeah. You should make some money on that. When you were Democrat, to follow up on that, did you think Republicans were racist?
I ran with the narrative. I thought Republicans were the racist, the people, the white people, the devil.
Why did you think that, Victor? Why did you think that?
Because that was the narrative that was being fed to me via, you know, the media. And working for Democratic Mayor Muriel Bowser, you see that every day. You know, the Republicans are racist. We need to fight against all that. We need to push the RT. And it's just not who I am. And I don't think this country is racist. Let me tell you something. I came from the Dominican Republic. I moved to this country from the Dominican Republic, and I went straight to Anchorage, Alaska. And I went to college in Anchorage, Alaska. I spoke very little English. I attended the university. I graduated. And let me tell you, I've never experienced anything that I would consider racist. And honestly, all the white people that I've encountered have bent over backwards to give me the opportunities to succeed, to give me the opportunities I needed to be great in this country. And so I feel like I am the true definition of the American dream. I remember when I lived in Anchorage, eating oatmeal and water for days because they didn't have any money.
You know, you have so much political experience, and you are a new Republican. We are running out of time, but just really quickly, what is your advice for Republicans running, particularly in inner cities, and trying to gain votes from people who may not traditionally vote for them?
So my advice would be to build a racial coalition like we saw with Glenn Youngkin. He reached out to everybody, and he talked about the issues that really matter to the community, like CRT in the state of Virginia. I know we need, when it comes about race, we need to talk about it. Of course, we need to teach the good and the bad, but making 7- and 10-year-olds feel bad about their skin color, it's just not the way to go. We've been there, we've done that, and it just does not work.
Victor.
And so we need to build.
Yeah, I was going to say, Victor Jimenez. I was just going to let you go here. Victor Jimenez, we are so curious to see what your next step is. Yes. We are looking forward to that. Please come back and share
it with us. A great idea for Fox News as well. And, thanks, Victor.
Thank you so much. Thank you.
Appreciate it.
Hi, everyone. I'm Brian Kilmeade. I want you to do me a favor. I want you to click to subscribe to the Fox News YouTube page. This is the only way that I know for sure that you're not going to miss any great commentary, any great news bites, any great interviews coming your way on Fox. You can get it all here on YouTube. So subscribe right now.